Acer Callers and Certified Installers. This week, we'll be talking about cell phone signals in a moderate level of depth to answer a few questions. How do cell phone signals work? What causes dropped calls, broken up cell reception, undelivered texts, and slow data? How can cell signals be improved in homes, buildings, or vehicles that have weak signals? So let's get into it. To explain each of these, we'll talk through uplink and downlink, signal penetration and reflection, touch on some common cell signal blockers, and then we'll talk about solutions. If you have any questions along the way, feel free to ask the questions in the comments below. So how does a cell phone signal work? In simplified terms, telecommunications travel in two directions, uplink and downlink. The easiest way to think about this is to picture yourself in front of a cell tower. When you make a call, you're sending the call up to the tower. This is called an uplink signal. When you receive a call, it comes down from the cell tower to your cell phone. This is called a downlink signal. These uplink and downlink transactions happen multiple times during a call, and the frequencies used are different for uplink and downlink. We've all experienced dropped or broken up calls, undelivered texts, and slow data. These are all caused by interruptions to those uplink and downlink cell signals, which result from a wide range of different materials and matter. Some of these materials have a weakening impact, which means they're only partially penetrable by cell signals. In addition, some materials will completely reflect a signal, which means the signal literally bounces off of them, preventing the signal from passing through. While there are many, some of the most common causes of a weak cell signal include non-conductive materials like drywall, plastics, wood, glass, and other materials that don't conduct electricity. Organic and topographic material like mountains, hills, snow, or dirt mounds, foliage, large lakes of fresh water, and more. Weather like fog, snow, rain, sleet, hail, dust, and others. RF interference caused by other devices that emit their own RF signal can disrupt your signal, but usually won't completely block a strong signal. User capacity is not infinite on cell towers, and as more phones simultaneously send and receive signals using the same tower, the amount of power the tower can provide to each user lessens, until there is nearly none at all. These last few have a very significant weakening impact on cell signals. A combination or high density of the signal killers we just mentioned, conductive construction materials like tin, copper, silver, aluminum, and others. Salt water has a serious impact, which means that beautiful plot of land you dream about living on in Hawaii might need a little help with cellular signal. A common solution that many people in the US, Canada, and Mexico use is a signal booster. Boosters can overcome many of these issues to improve cellular coverage in apartments, homes, offices, cars, trucks, and RVs. Essentially, signal boosters use an outside antenna to capture the signal outside of the space. The booster strengthens and improves the uplink and downlink cell signals, and the internal antenna, or antennas, distribute the signal wherever you need it. To learn more about how cell phone signal boosters work, click the link below to check out our master guide to cell phone signal boosters, or check out some of our other videos for similar information. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and if you have any suggestions for future topics, let us know in the comments, and you might just see a video dedicated to your suggested topic.